So, I know that road cycling is considered to be extremely unsafe in our country, and if you're not careful, it really is. But that is not to say that we cannot make it safer for ourselves. Hi guys, welcome back to Coffee Shop, and damn, does it feel good to be back. So, to start with, as a rule, and there's only one, you always have to wear a helmet. Now, this is the only point that is not up for debate, and it does not matter how close to your house you ride, how far, how big a group, how small a group, how slow, fast, anything. You always have to wear a helmet. See, your helmet is the only thing you have in case something bad were to happen to you on the road, and for that reason, this point is non-negotiable. So, if you're on your bike, you always, always, always need to have your helmet on and strap tightly. Now, an add-on point to this, which I personally think should be compulsory, is to always have a pair of lights on your cycle. This point is especially more important if you plan to ride out when it's dark, early morning or late night. Not only do you have to make sure that you can see the road, but you also have to make sure that other people around can see you. So, for my backlight, I use this one from Cat Eye. Works really well, very long battery life, blinks really fast, and is bright enough, gets the job done. For my front light, I have this one from Lezyne. This is the Lezyne Micro Pro 800XL. Not a cheap light, 800 lumens, but since I ride at 4 a.m. in the morning and my rides go up for 3 to 4 hours, gets the job done for me. Now, these two together not only make sure that I can see the road, but also make sure that other people around can see me. Highly, highly recommended. Now, as long as you get these points in check, your helmet and your lights, you are pretty good to go. You are as safe as you can be without practice, and that's the important part, practice. Of course, to understand how to ride on the road along with cars and traffic, you just need practice, and there's no escape to that. But you can always join a cycling group. More on that later. Another thing you can do when you're out riding is to carry an ID card with you. Now, this is a simple ID card: your name, your address, your blood group, and an emergency contacts number. Along with this, it's also a good idea to share your live location with someone you live with, your friends, family, roommate, whatever. Not only will it make sure that they know where you are, but it's also for everyone's peace of mind. Now, moving on to the next thing on your list of priority should be to carry spare tubes and a toolkit. Now, this includes everything you need if you ride into a mechanical problem when you're out on the road, and the most common one of that being a puncture. So, always carry an extra tube with a pump to fill air inside. Along with that, a toolkit. Now, in case you don't want to buy an entire toolkit as of now, the minimum that you should be having is a 4, 5, and a 6 mm Allen key. Now, these will make sure that you can take care of most problems that can happen when you're out for a ride, and so you should always have one with you. Now, getting away from all the cycling and the mechanical aspects, the next important point: hydration and food. Now, this seems rather obvious but is often overlooked when you just begin. See, when you cycle, you sweat just as much as any other sport, but since you're moving really quickly through the wind, it just evaporates a lot quicker. But you still sweat just as much. This can and will make you neglect drinking or even carrying enough water for your rides, and you can very easily ride into dehydration. Similarly, cycling seems to be easier and more relaxed than the other sports, but even that requires you to have adequate fuel. So, for that reason, always carry something with you when you're out riding to eat. If not, at least cash to buy something. You will thank me later. It's always better to have food which you don't end up needing than to need that food and not having it. Now, the next point is optional, but in my opinion, the best thing you can do when you just get into cycling: join a group or find a riding buddy. If you're an absolute beginner, just join a cycling group. I know cycling is complicated to get into, but joining a group will solve all of those problems. I did that, most people I know did that, and so should you. Start riding with more experienced riders, and believe me, they will help you until you're okay to ride on your own. Not only that, but riding in a group is as safe as it can get. And later on, as you keep improving and your training gets more serious, find a couple of riders who have similar plans and speed as you and start riding with them. And now, to end with, I would like to leave you with one thought. Imagine cycling to be like learning how to drive a car. In the beginning, you have absolutely no idea what you're doing, and you are scared to be on the roads, and rightfully so. But once you get the hang of it, once you've had enough practice, it becomes second nature. And the exact same thing will happen with cycling. It's just gonna take a bit of practice to get used to, and then you will be safe on the roads. So, helmets, lights, ID, tools, and hydration. keep these five things in mind and your journey into the sport will be as smooth and as safe as it can get. Fun fact, even though I started off with running, cycling very quickly overtook that to become my favorite sport. But don't worry, running is still a very, very close second. Anyways, let me know if there are any tactics you use to be safer on the road, something I haven't covered, and while you're at it, hit the like button. Subscribe to Coffee Shop only if you wish to do so, and I'll see you around.